Hello flight simmers, welcome back to the channel. This video is going to be a small cockpit update video. We're going to be looking at the ARC 164 HAVQuick 2. Flight time.
Okay, knock it off.
Okay, so these are the two radio heads that I have now built for the simulator. This first one that I originally had in is an ARC 164 HAVQuick 2A. This is a replica made by AIC. Unfortunately, the creator is no longer with us, but it's a great little replica and it works perfectly. Basically, what I did was I purchased one of these HAVQuick 2s before. And I ripped all the switches and knobs out and basically populated this, making it a more aesthetically pleasing replica. So there's nothing really wrong with it. It works great, looks great. The only issue that I kind of didn't like about it is these four switches here and the channel preset are just cheap eBay encoders. And, you know, the knobs are real, but turning them is just kind of flimsy and just doesn't really feel like any type of mil-spec hardware. So eventually, I want to rebuild this one with something a little better. I did get my hands on a real ARC 164 2A panel here. So at one point, my next project will be to complete this one, combine these two together, and make a better replica. So currently, right now, what I have in is this one. This is a HAVQuick 2. I'm really happy about this, as it's a complete real radio head. All the switches, obviously because it's real, they just got that nice tactile feel to it as it is a real radio. But more importantly, what I do like is that this is currently what is used in the HAV PX2 Block 50 aircraft. So the first thing we have to do is we've got to start off with one of these HAVQuick 1 radios. This is actually the third one that I've purchased in the 15 years I've been building simulators. Shamefully, I have to admit that when I've taken the parts off that I needed, I've tossed the other two in the garbage. So anyways, got my hands on another HAVQuick 1 radio head. Normally when you buy them, they don't have the module underneath. So I needed to build one of these, which really serves as a purpose of holding the electronics. So that was easy, as just using some standoff rods that go right into the head itself. And then I built some steel plating on the back and bottom just to hold my connectors and electronics. Then you have to basically build connectors, because as far as I know, we in the sim building community, we haven't been able to find the proper connectors for these. So a little bit tedious, but fairly simple to make. And using the work of others, another builder and I were able to find the appropriate pins that are needed, and he did all the pull blocks coding. I can't take any credit for that at all. I don't really understand that stuff, and I don't think I ever will. But basically with the pull blocks coding, it keeps it all synced in with BMS. So regardless of what channel you're set at, as soon as you get into BMS, it'll sync it all up and vice versa. So it works very well in the game. All the switches work, except for the squelch, simply because that's not used in BMS or the tone. They're wired up, they work, they just have no function in the sim. The newer coding also has this preset switch working, which was done after I got this finish. I just didn't bother modifying it because I don't really see a use for this button. But if anybody chooses to follow up with this project, you can make use of this preset switch, which, who knows, could be used as a in-game pause or whatever you want. But in the end, it works fine. I didn't bother making it work. The volume knob works as well. In order for me to get the volume knob to work, I had to run a ground straight off the ground pin into the pokies. However, I was told by the other sim builder who helped me out here that he had found a ground pin that works. I didn't bother changing it just because I already had a setup. So anybody new doing this, you should be able to get everything functioning by just running off the pins rather than running a direct ground like I did. The only bad part about this project is the side pin connector. As you can see on a profile view, it protrudes out of the head. They must have some 90 degree bend connector. I wasn't able to do that. But the only issue I have is putting her right up against the Audio One panel is I had to remove the box off it in order to make clearance so it doesn't jam in. I probably could jam it in with the box on, but I didn't want to risk breaking these connectors or anything. So I just removed the covering box, and that basically solved that issue to get it in. One of the last pieces I added to this panel to make it more complete was I replaced this top plate, as this is a Havquick One radio, with this other plate that has this tiny sticker, EMB, which I believe stands for Expanded Motherboard or Enhanced Motherboard. I think it's expanded, but basically this makes it a Havquick 2 radio, thus making it more accurate to what's in the PX2 cockpits. If you want any of the information, the schematics or the pull blocks code, just shoot me an email and I'll certainly pass it on so you can get one of these working and make it a great addition to your pit. So once again, like and subscribe, and we'll keep more videos coming your way.